1953. No, it had nothing to do with Eisenhower. No, no. It's a cellar down there. It's very damp and clammy. You don't want to go down there. Trust me, you get sick. Suffocating, nauseating. The smell of the clamminess and the mildew and everything. Smells unbearable. It gets in your clothes. There was no accident down there. It didn't blow up or catch on fire. It wasn't so dramatic. I mean, no, no, never mind. No. Never mind. What's a smart girl like you going around asking old ladies about their down there's? I didn't do this kind of thing when I was a girl. What? Jesus, okay, okay. There was this boy, Andy Leftcove. Oh, he was cute. Well, I thought so. And tall, like me. And I really liked him. He asked me out for a date in his car. I can't tell you this. No, I can't do this talk about down there. You just know it's there. It's like the cellar. There are rumbles down there. So you can hear the pipes and things get caught there. Like little animals and things. And sometimes it gets wet. And you know what? Sometimes people have to plug up the leaks. Otherwise, the door stays closed. You forget about it. I mean, it's part of the house, but you just don't see or think about it. I mean, it has to be there, though, because every house needs a cellar. Otherwise, the bedroom would be in the basement. Oh, Andy! Andy Leftcove, right? Oh, he was good looking. He was a catch. That's what we used to call it in my day. He took me out of his car. A new white Chevy Bel Air. Ooh! I remember thinking that my legs were too long for the seats. Ah, I have long legs. Anyway, they were smushed up against the dashboard, and I was looking at my big kneecaps when all of a sudden he kissed me in this "Take Me by Control." And well, I got excited. So excited, and, well, there was a flood down there. I couldn't control it. It was like this river of life. This flood of passion just came right out of me. Right through my panties and right onto the car seat of the new white Chevy Bel Air. It wasn't pink, and it was smelly.
Oh, my God.
Well, frankly, I didn't smell anything at all. But he said, Andy said that it smelled like sour milk and it was staining his car seat.
Oh my God.
I was a stinky weird girl, he said.
That's so funny.
I wanted to tell him that his kiss had caught me off guard, that I wasn't normally like this. Oh. I tried whipping the flood up with my dress. It was a new yellow primrose dress and it looked so ugly with the flood on it. Andy drove me home without saying another word. And when I got out and closed the door, closed the whole store, locked it up, never opened for business again. I dated some after that, but the thought of flooding made me a little too nervous. I never got close again. Oh, I used to have dreams. Crazy dreams. What? Oh, they're dopey. Why? Burt Reynolds. I don't know why he didn't do much for me in my life, but in my dreams, it was always Burt and I. Burt and I. Burt and I. It was always the same dream. We'd be out, Bert and I, at some restaurant like the kind you see in Atlantic City, all big with the chandeliers and thousands of waiters with the little vests. Oh. And he'd give me an orchid corsage. I'd pin it on my blazer, and we would laugh. We were always laughing, Bert and I. Laughing, laughing. We'd eat shrimp cocktail. Huge shrimp! Fabulous shrimp! Oh, and we'd laugh some more. We were very happy together. And then he'd look into my eyes and pull me close in the middle of the restaurant. And just as he was about to kiss me, the whole restaurant would start to shake. Pigeons would come flying from underneath the table.
About this, and well, I feel a little better now.